In today's video, we're gonna learn how to make an Excel sheet accessible. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's jump right in. All right, Excel can sometimes be a little tricky to make accessible. Let's start off with some best practices. The first thing I wanna do is put a description into cell A1. But right now I have this ID column. Let's add in a new row right above there. And in cell A1, I'm going to give a description for screen reader users on how to access this content. So we're gonna say this sheet represents customers, date of purchase, amount, and category. We could add extra information like the amounts are found in column D. We wanna try to be specific with our cell A1 description. I also want to add in a formatting characteristic. I'm going to right click cell A1, go to format cells, and in this pop-up box, I want to select wrap text and then select okay. This is going to make cell A1 a little wider, but it also will help with printing this content later on. And then let's add in another row above where this table data begins. And I want to put a label in. Let's make this a heading. So I'm going to say customer information. And in this cell under the home tab, I'm going to apply a cell style. And in this example, I want it to be a heading level 1. Next, we need to make sure our table is actually accessible with our data. To do this, I'm going to select all of the content that should be inside of a table, and then I'm going to select the insert button and then select table. We want to make sure that we use the checkbox my table has headers and then select okay. This automatically applies a table style. I want to choose my own table style from the table design tab. I personally like very boring styles. I'm going to choose this black on white. And then we want to ensure that we have header row. And then let's do first column as well. And then one other important piece here. I want to give this table a name. It all has to be one word. So let's say customer info. That's going to be the name of this table. I then want to select the home tab and I actually want to center all of the data. So I'm going to press this center key on the alignment tab a couple of times to make sure everything is centered appropriately. Next, in cell A14, I'm going to put the words end of worksheet. And oops, it seems to have put that inside of my table. I actually don't want that inside of the table. So let's undo that. We'll do end of worksheet. And then we could delete this blank row. And now I'm going to assign a cell style to end of worksheet. And we'll just go ahead and do heading level 2. So now our content is sort of chunked appropriately. It looks like our table became uncentered somehow. So we'll center that again. We now have our heading 1. We have a heading 2 in here. Next, we need to rename the sheet. I'm going to double click in sheet 1 and update it to customer information. Next, let's add in our metadata. I'm going to select file, info, under properties, advanced properties, let's add in a title. The title of this document is customer information. The subject is demo document for Excel accessibility. The author is the accessibility guy. And our keywords are going to be Excel accessibility and select okay. Now the final step is let's go ahead and run the built-in accessibility check. I'm going to select file, info, check for issues, check accessibility, and we have no errors in this document. Now I would like to add that it's really easy to have a complicated Excel document. The demo that I went over today was a relatively easy document that had some easy sample data. Keep your Excel content simple. If you have more complex data, it might make sense to take it into a PDF or even HTML. And lastly, if you want to find out how I can help you get accessible, take a look at the link in the description of this video. And as always, I could be your champion for inclusion. Thank you so much for joining me today, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button.